नमस्ते, हाय, हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू द चैनल। सो इन द लास्ट वीक सेशन, लास्ट सेशन, सो वी वर डिस्कसिंग ए कॉन्सेप्ट फ्रॉम द चैप्टर नेशनलिज्म इन इंडिया, एंड द प्रीवियस कॉन्सेप्ट वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द साल्ट मार्च एंड द सिविल डिसोबीडियंस मूवमेंट। So half of the concept was mainly discussed. So Mahatma Gandhiji, he found salt as a most powerful weapon or symbol which can unite the nation. That's why on 31st January 1930 he sent a letter to Viceroy Irwin stating about his 11 demands. So among 11 demands, some are of general interest and others are of specific interest relating or concerning to different classes from different group of people, from peasants to industrialists. So this idea, it made wide ranging success, so that all the different classes within Indian society could identify with them, and everyone could brought together in an united campaign with the div ideas, demands of Mahatma Gandhi. Then most importantly, among 11 demands, the most important demand of Mahatma Gandhiji, it is the abolition of salt tax, because salt is one of the important material. It is something which was mainly consumed by all the different class of people. They may be rich or poor, and it was one of the important essential food item too. So that's why the tax on salt and the government monopoly over the salt production. So opposing this, Mahatma Gandhi declared to reveal it as the most oppressive phase to condemn or criticize British rule. So Mahatma Gandhiji's letter was in a way an ultimatum. If the demands were not fulfilled by 11th March, the letter stated, the Congress would launch civil disobedience campaign, and for that Irwin was unwilling to negotiate. So here Mahatma Gandhiji's demands were not accepted and approved by Viceroy Irwin, so Irwin completely refuses, and when he refused, then Congress and Mahatma Gandhiji, they launched civil disobedience movement on 11th March onwards. So Mahatma Gandhiji, he started his famous salt march accompanied by 78 different people of different groups, one who is trusted by Mahatma Gandhiji, or they are mainly trusted volunteers. So Gandhiji's salt march, it mainly about to cover 240 miles from his ashram at Sabarmati to Gujarati coastal town or seashore at Dandi. Gandhiji, along with his volunteers, walked, covered 240 miles in 24 days, about 10 miles a day. Thousands of people came to hear about Mahatma Gandhi and
Dandi March. Wherever Mahatma Gandhiji stopped, he conversed with them about what he exactly meant by Swaraj and what he really urged them to peacefully defy the British. Here defy means fight against the British. Finally, on 6th April, Mahatma Gandhiji and his volunteers reached Dandi, and there ceremonially means with zeal they violated, they broke the salt law by manufacturing salt by boiling sea water. This is Dandi March, or a civil disobedience movement launched by Mahatma Gandhiji. So let me stop up to here. So after this, after violating the salt law, after manufacturing salt at Dandi, so it rapidly creates some of the impacts on the political leaders, including Mahatma Gandhiji and others. So what impact it made, so about that we will discuss in tomorrow's session. So until then, take care of yourself, stay at home, stay safe. Thank you one and all.